Well, the cost of construction would not in itself be less. The cost of operating a central library would likewise be approximately the same wherever the library is located. But there are some other factors that must be looked at also. First, the Carter Square site, in our opinion, does not have adequate bus transportation to it at the moment. If a library were built there, we believe that adequate bus transportation should be provided. Likewise, if a library were constructed at Carter Square, it would leave approximately 40,000 people that come downtown every day without adequate library service. And we would recommend that a downtown branch, I guess is a good name for it, should be operated there.
Mr. Gillespie, there's been a lot of talk and a lot of speculation already in this issue, and we'd like to clear it up once and for all. Has there been undue pressure brought to bear on the library board from any section or any group of downtown businessmen to bring this to a downtown site?
No, sir. There has been absolutely no pressure as such brought to bear on me, any other board of which I'm aware, and none brought to bear on the library administration. One thing I should say, since one always wonders about such things, that is that no member of the site selection committee nor any member of the board participating in the decision on this matter either owns or has an interest in any real estate anywhere within the vicinity of any of the sites that we've considered.
Thanks.
Once you've gotten a plea of not guilty, how long does it normally take to process it, and what's involved? Is there some problem with the prosecutor?
Well, normally misdemeanors are handled within between 30 and 45 days of the date of the alleged offense in this court.
Well, as president of the Lefthanders of Texas, I think you have some plans for the association. Would you tell me how you plan to enlarge the membership?
Well, we're going to have meetings throughout the state. We had a spring warm-up down in South Texas at McAllen this year. We had another one in Houston. We're having the state amateur tournament here at Shady Oaks. And in the fall, we're going to have a member lefty over at the Irving Country Club. And as you know, Pinky Tharp is the pro lefty pro over there.
Sorry, I'm not familiar with the complaint of Dr. Matthews regarding the delinquent tax notice. However, in the past, when a piece of property is sold, the new owner files a deed in the county, the only information we get is the owner's name. We do not have the address. We have a research department that spends 12 months out of the year trying to locate people when they buy a new property. The law says very clear that you should go to the tax office, render, and pay your taxes. We have two tax rolls. One is the rendered roll where people come in and render their taxes. The other is the unrendered roll, which we do not have addresses on. I am sure that this tax statement went to the former owner. Very, very seldom do we ever have a former owner send it back to us and give us the name of the party he sold the property to. If Dr. Matthews would come in and contact me personally, I'm sure we can work out this problem.
If you fail to act, we fear that the people charged with the responsibility of what to do about Ed Pope will interpret it as a sanction of his action.
As abominable as both things that this man is representing these people have done. That is, one of them has sold this filth that Mr. Poteet came and protested before us a couple of weeks ago. The other one wore the American flag sewed to the back of his breeches. As bad as that is, would you deny these people the right to counsel under the American way?
We are directly or indirectly sponsors of the War on Poverty program, which is connected with, however so remotely, the Legal Services Project Board. And we do have a responsibility, I think, to create this investigation. But be that as it may, the committee has deferred action on it until next week, and I think we shall see at that time.
What is so obnoxious about the man's body when Dallas buses are carrying a nude woman right now on the side of the buses?
Here at the Dallas County Courthouse, District Attorney Henry Wade promises his utmost cooperation with the city's all-out campaign against pornography. Mr. Wade's best trial records during the past 2 years ranges from out-and-out losses of verdicts in smutty bookcases to federal court reversals of dirty picture prosecution. The record reflects the district attorney's best efforts in the past have been thwarted by either strong defense or weak prosecution. What Mr. Wade's best will be in this new city endeavor remains to be seen, as he refuses to say, as he has a couple of cases now working. One feature of this new law is that officers cannot immediately seize evidence and impound it. They must now either buy the material in question or snap pictures of it. The evidence is then brought before a district judge for his ruling. It's then up to the judge to decide whether the evidence is questionable and should be seized. At any rate, the district attorney will do his utmost best with the city's best laid plans. Carl Mayo, Channel 8 News.